So basically, I had been serving ever since I was born. When I was 8 years old, I was traveling around the world with my mom and dad as a military brat, an Air Force brat. My father was career enlisted. And so my daily life was, of course, going to school and everything else, and always every 2 years meeting new friends. And I even knew probably around that time frame that I wanted to grow up to be just like my dad. Didn't have a clue as to what he did. I knew he wore a light blue shirt and dark blue pants. And every 2 years we moved to someplace really wonderful. The attraction to flying came to me, number one, as an opportunity. So I was a freshman in college. I had a ROTC scholarship. And my ROTC instructor said, "Have you ever thought about flying?" And I go, "I fly all the time." And he goes, "No, as the pilot." And I'm like, "Yeah, why not?" And so that spurred my interest. It was a pretty normal journey, except for when they asked me if I wanted to apply for pilot training, I said yes. And so I competed for a pilot training scholarship and was awarded that scholarship. My senior year, my eyes did not pass the physical. And so I was told that I would go on active duty as an engineer, which was what my degree is. And then if my eyes somehow got better, then I could reapply for pilot training. And so that's exactly what I did. So I tell people I ate carrots, I did eye exercises, everything I could. I went on active duty at Hill Air Force Base as a civil engineer, and told my boss I would do the very best job I could for him if he would support me in reapplying for pilot training. So eyes got better, I worked hard, they supported me in my package, I reapplied for pilot training, then was accepted, and then went to pilot training. So that's kind of my journey from, I know you asked to oath, but it was my journey from ROTC to piloting.
So far in your career?
It's been a wonderful career because initially I flew the C-141, which was basically the airlines of the military. So once again, was able to fulfill that dream of traveling around the world. So Operation Iraqi Freedom recently, Operation Enduring Freedom, Operation Deep Freeze down to Antarctica, a host of humanitarian missions. So it's really been a joy to serve. Well, a day in the life for me is actually, it's pretty easy because I tell my airmen I'm there to serve them. So I know when I wake up in the morning that I'm going to be serving airmen, and I tell them to give me their taskings, and I will be their top cover, and I will try to solve as many issues and challenges as they have. Great question, because my most challenging has been my most rewarding, and that's leading and commanding. Because everyone's situation is unique, every airman counts, and so you're always trying to do right by your airman, by serving your airman, and it's always a challenge, but always very rewarding. Everybody's really excited. Both of my parents are deceased now. My mother passed away when I was in college, but my father saw me to the point where I was selected for colonel. Friends are immensely proud of me, and I really call my friends my family. I made the choice that to not have children, but I tell people after especially commanding a wing, I had about 1,300 children at one time. So, and all the pains and hardships and all the joys and rewards go with it. I think that it would be, number one, more balanced, just like our nation is, nearly 50%. I think policies that affect women would be more quickly enacted, so I think it would just create a more balanced military. The reality is that women are learning more about the military in so many more career fields. I think it's like 99.9% are open to women now, which I think that is fantastic. I can't imagine not being an airman. It's what I was born to do, and regardless of what my gender is, I think it should be open for everybody. That sense of community, absolutely. Especially when you're on active duty, you enjoy it, and then when you make that choice to go to the Air Force Reserve, you still have that propensity to serve that's deep down inside you. And it's that sense of community that really draws you back into the military. And that's what I'll miss the most when I have to retire. No time soon. to serve your nation. And I think it's an honor and a privilege to be able to serve our nation.